Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2019 NHRA Awards. Please welcome to the stage, Brian Loans.
Hello, everybody, and welcome once again to the 2019 NHRA Awards. I trust you have enjoyed your dinner. I trust you will enjoy the show that we have prepared for you all tonight. It's going to be a great night. We're going to celebrate the hard work, the skill, the talent, the acumen, the dedication that NHRA drag racers at a professional level have in our series. Later on tonight, we're going to honor a legend, an icon, someone that has really kind of formed and shaped the way that we race on a professional level today. And a lot of you are thinking you know who this person is. And I promise you that it is not Lewis Bloom. It is not him. The stat guy not getting that award tonight. Maybe next year. But tonight is not the stat guy's night. This jacket is not made from the drapes of a Vegas casino. It was given to me or loaned to me by Mr. Carducci. Many of you are addressed by Mr. Carducci. The Dooch, right? The Dooch. We are here at the Adult Drag Racing Prom, and Mr. Carducci dresses the majority of us at the Adult Drag Racing Prom. So the Dooch is awesome, and he's been a part of this thing forever. How about race day yesterday? How about a Sunday that was like the most unpredictable thing anybody in the world of drag racing had ever seen? The tension, like right from the beginning of the morning. You had Erica and Greg, the setup for 2 days. They're going through qualifying, and Greg's hunting Erica and trying, and the lines are up. And anybody that's ever seen Richard Freeman on the starting line knows that he's always up there kind of tweaking his beard. That thing, it caught fire. He was tweaking so hard, the water box guy blasted him with the hose, but it was up in smoke at one point. Where is Gianna Salinas at? Where is Gianna Salinas at? Stand up for a second. Gianna Salinas, stand up, wherever you're at. So here's the reason, right? So, like a singular study in being dedicated and being driven and being focused and in staying on path to achieve the goal. You did something yesterday that was absolutely phenomenal. For a lot of people in this room, it was not so phenomenal, but I promise you, for the people that watched that show, for the people that were at the racetrack yesterday, for all the people that went berserk in the grandstands when you won that race, you proved a lot of stuff to a lot of people. So congratulations, Gianna, for that first national event win. It was amazing, totally spectacular. Robert Height proved to us in a final round that you cannot stand on the throttle stop of a funny car for like a minute and a half doing a burnout. Just doesn't like it. Jack Beckman says, do it all day. I love it. The whole day was crazy. I mean, everything about that day was absolutely spectacular. How about Coletta Motorsports? Connie Coletta is in drag racing for 60 years, the end of his 60th year in the sport of drag racing, and his two top fuel dragsters are the last two cars to go down a racetrack in the 2019 season. Absolutely stunning stuff at Pomona, California. We know the audience reacted to everything that happened yesterday. The internet's been completely on fire after the race. So nights like tonight are a big deal. It's a big deal not only for our industry, but for us as people. We get to kind of show off what we've done for the year. When you get a guy like Richard Hogan, who goes to the nearest Tractor Supply, buys fresh camo to come into the room tonight just to put on a good show, that is the importance of the night, right? This guy's looking perfect. Everything's good. You got force. Did not wear the dress jeans tonight. Put on the suit. It's looking great. Everybody looks good, and it's a way for us to celebrate and kind of show off everything that's happened over the course of the 2019 season. Now, 2019 has provided incredible action for us on the racetrack and off of it. And to get things started tonight, we're going to take a look back over the 2019 NHRA Mellow Yellow Drag Racing season.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Make way for the new kings.
We are the new kings, winning this fight tonight with our name lit up in lights. We are the new kings, this is our time to shine. Set it off like dynamite.
Address the court from the throne, newly minted. Yeah. Crown adorned the dome, you want it, come and get it. Noble bloodline, vintage, rule with an iron fist. This is how we do business. My squad go ballistic. Swords, force to steal. Running towards the field. Hundreds more to deal. Give them something more to reel. The legacy that we bring. When that last bell rings, they will remember one thing.
We are the new kings. Winning this fight tonight. With our name lit up in lights. We are the new
till we touch down. Then they wonder what now. Loud like the sound of the crowd when it's sold out. Lead the charge, it's so epic. They gotta respect it. Professors will hold lectures, so you'll never forget it. The legacy that we bring, when that last bell rings, they will remember one thing.
We are the new kings, winning this fight tonight with our name lit.
Gentlemen, please welcome the president of the National Hot Rod Association, Glenn Cromwell.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for being here tonight to celebrate our 2019 NHRA Mel Yello Drag Racing Series champions. Congratulations to Steve Torrance and Top Fuel. Robert Height in Funny Car. Erica Enders in Pro Stock. And Andrew Hines in Pro Stock Motorcycle. Give them all an applause. Great job, all of you. We had the privilege again this year to partner with the Coca-Cola Company and its Mel Yello brand as a sponsor of our premier professional racing series. Tonight marks the end of our 18th season together. That's just amazing, and we can't thank everyone at the Coca-Cola Company enough for their support, their confidence in the sport, and their friendship. We all appreciate the Coca-Cola Company's involvement in our world, which supports the continued success of the sport. On behalf of everyone at the NHRA, we are honored to be associated with such an outstanding company. I'd like to thank Al Rondon, who is here tonight from the Coca-Cola Company. Please put your hands together for Al Rondon. In 2019 was the fourth year of our broadcast partnership with Fox Sports. Together, we continue to grow the sport with new opportunities as Fox brings NHRA drag racing excitement to more and more people on its strong platforms. Thank you to everyone who is here tonight from Fox. Put your hands together for all of them. I know many of our national event track partners are here tonight, and I'd like to thank all of you, for everything you do to make the NHRA grow. You provide the platform for champions to be made. We also want to thank and recognize the owners, drivers, crew chiefs, and all the team members who make the sport what it is, and their sponsors. Every person here tonight contributes in some way to the success of NHRA drag racing. From the PR reps, to the crew chiefs, to the owners and drivers, and countless other people necessary to make those few seconds on the track happen. Thank you for all you do. Please put your hands together for all of them. We especially want to recognize and honor our nation's first responders, including our own safety safari, who we all depend on. Put a big hand together for our safety safari. I am honored and humbled to stand here tonight looking at what Wally Parks set in motion almost 70 years ago. Wally has been gone for 12 years now, but we at the NHRA always remember him and try every day to honor his vision. I think Wally would be overwhelmed if he could see how far we have come and the incredible opportunities ahead of us. Our sport is poised for growth as we look toward the 2020 season. The future could not be brighter. On behalf of all of us at the NHRA, thank you to everyone for being here tonight. We wish you the best during the off season and look forward to seeing you in Pomona in February. Thank you.
And now, please welcome the Senior Marketing Manager for the Coca-Cola Company, Al Rondon.
Good evening. It's a real honor and a privilege to be celebrating here with you tonight and representing the Coca-Cola Company and our brand, Mellow Yellow. And on behalf of our company, I would like to congratulate Erica Enders, Andrew Hines, Robert Height, and Steve Torrance on their 2019 championship. What an amazing year you and your team have had on the path to earn your championship. So congratulations. And I'd also like to extend a congratulation to all of the NHRA drivers and the teams for what has been an exciting 2019 season for the NHRA Mellow Yellow Drag Racing Series. Yesterday, our race day was a perfect example of the excitement that our fans have had to witness in 2019. Thank you to all of you who have supported and enjoyed our brands, especially those during the top end interviews. So thank you. And I would like to take a few moments just to thank some additional folks who, without them, we could not have the success that we've had thus far. A big heartfelt thanks to my team at Red Moon Marketing, Mike Adams, Jim Bailey, Chris Tucker, Brian Newhouse, and especially Chase Gregory, who went above and beyond for our team this year. We had some big challenges, and I needed Red Moon's commitment and partnership more than ever before, and to no surprise, they over-delivered. So I'm deeply grateful for the passion and the professionalism that you do in everything, and I'm truly blessed to have you as my partner, so thank you. I'd like to thank the Coca-Cola bottlers and the NHRA track owners for their support of Mellow Yellow and the NHRA, because their support allowed us to bring our programs to life with our customers in each of the race markets. I'd like to thank Steve Righteous and his amazing NHRA on Fox production crew. I'm so proud of working with him on the My Journey series, and this year's features were certainly outstanding and award-worthy. Thank you to the drivers who shared their stories. I think the stories this year were incredibly emotional, uplifting, and courageous. And I'm so glad that Mellow Yellow was there to share in those moments. And then lastly, I'd like to thank Glenn Cromwell and his entire NHRA leadership team for their tremendous support. But I would like to recognize and applaud two of those leaders, Evan Jonette and Melissa Coleman. Thank you. They worked tirelessly, just like tonight, behind the scenes, not only to support me and my team, but the drivers, and more importantly, our wonderful NHRA fans. So I'm so appreciative of their partnership, and I look forward to continuing that together. And in closing, I'd be remiss if I didn't ask you all for your continued support of Mellow Yellow and all of our Coca-Cola brands. With all of you as our ambassadors, we're bound to have continued success for Mellow Yellow. So thank you, congratulations, and best of luck in 2020. Enjoy your evening. Thank you.
Welcome to the stage, Lewis Bloom.
What a nice welcome. And anytime I can be in a room where Don Prudhomme is right there, it's a good night. Thanks, Snake, for coming out. It is a great honor to introduce this year's Lucas Oil Sportsman Champions. But I do have to mention two champions are not here tonight. One is Ty Tharp, who won the Mickey Thompson Tire Top Fuel Harley Davidson Series. Exactly. And our E3 Spark Plugs J&A Service Pro Mod Champion, Mr. Personality, Stevie Fast Jackson. I'd like to bring up Tom Bogner from Lucas Oil, Jack Carr driver, Lucas Oil rep at the races. Earlier today at the Hard Rock Cafe, the Lucas Oil champions celebrated their accomplishments with their crew, their family, and friends. Most of us in this room know the commitment it takes to win either a Mellow Yellow Series Championship or a Lucas Oil Series Championship. And some in the room know what it takes to win both. Steve Torrance, Jack Beckman, Sean Langdon, Jay Coughlin, Jason Line, have Bo Butner, have all accomplished the feat of winning championships in both series. The class of 2019 is one of the most unique in the history of the Lucas Oil Series. When you include factory stock, eight of the champions are first-time champions here, and two women have made history. And now let's meet our 2019 Lucas Oil Sportsman Series champions. Our top alcohol dragster champion is the 21st in the history of the category, and yes, the first woman. From Kansas, Megan Meyer. Our top alcohol funny car champion won last year, his second consecutive title, driving for the one and only Tony Bartone. From California, Sean Bellamure. Our comp eliminator champion comes from the great town of Freehold, New Jersey. I had to do that. He's a three-time champion, back-to-back seasons. I've known his family a long time. Frank Aragona Jr. Our super stock champion is Vic Penrod. He actually went to the banquet earlier, but his wife had to go to work. He's on the way home, driving 20 hours. Going back to Oklahoma, wherever you are, Vic, we applaud you and your dedication to the sport of drag racing. Our stock champion made a lot of history. First up, she's the first woman to win the stock champion, and her husband, Doug, is a former comp champion. The first husband and wife NHRA champions from Massachusetts, Allison Dahl. Our next champion builds the race car, he drives the race car, Ray Miller III from Tennessee, the Supercomp champion. Another first-time champion, Supergas, driving a steel-bodied race car. If you know the index classes, that's a big deal. From Kentucky, Jeremy Mason. Our Racing RV's top sportsman champion learned of his title by watching the live stream from his couch from the Vegas points race. He wasn't even there. From North Carolina, Sandy Wilkins. The RacingRVs.com champion is from Arkansas. His first championship, Danny Nelson. And finally, our last of our champions. You know him from Pro Stock. He's a former Indy winner, racing in the Samtech Factory Stock Showdown, driving a Cobra Jet. Double up Drew's name, and he is from Indiana, Drew Skillman. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, your 2019 Lucas Oil Series champions.
Here's Joe Costello.
Thank you very much. Good evening, racers. What a night. We are working hard to make sure you all get to the after party. And of course, a warm welcome to all the families who have attended tonight. We appreciate you and what you've had to deal with on this season-long winding road that is the NHRA Mellow Yellow Drag Racing Series. Now, we all know that Pro Stock Motorcycle as a class has to fight for respect in the 330 mile per hour world of nitro drag racing. They're not strapped in, they hold on. They're not surrounded by steel, but they must have courage of steel to do what they do. And these six-second rockets always put on a dramatic show for the fans. And sometimes things get a little crazy, as indicated by what we saw at the Auto Club Finals just yesterday. And on that note, let's pay a little tribute to our newest Pro Stock Motorcycle winner, Gianna Salinas. Gianna, you have been a great addition to the NHRA, and there is no doubt that you'll be standing on this stage in the near future. Now, over the course of their 16-race schedule, there have been six different winners, six different number one qualifiers. And while the racers are out there trying their best, some of them are earning their living doing this, while some spend their earnings to do this. And they all have made the commitment to the challenge that is NHRA Mellow Yellow Drag Racing. So let's take a look back at the 2019 Mellow Yellow Pro Stock Motorcycle season.
To the finish line, and it's going to be Andrew Hines starting his year with a win. It is Hector Arana Jr. on a hole shot. The win light will come on for Andrew Hines. This is his 50th career win. red light triggered on the starting line as Jerry Savoie goes down with a wind light on.
Look at this. Karen Stouffer takes care of business.
And now it's time to meet your 2019 Pro Stock Motorcycle Top 10. Coming to the stage, number 10, he is your 2009 Pro Stock Motorcycle World Champion, Hector Arana. Number 9, from Chicago, grit and determination is this man's hallmark. Started his own team and is doing it all himself. Flying Ryan Ayler. Number 8, she is the heart and soul of Matt Smith Racing. Made the top 10 now for 3 years in a row, Angie Smith. Number 7 is the winningest lady racer in NHRA history, a 3-time champ, and next year she'll be back on a Vance & Hines Harley-Davidson, Angel Sampe. Number 6, the first motorcycle racer over 200 miles an hour, Hector Arana Jr. Number 5, a 4-time world champion. One moment. And now, from Screaming Eagle Vance & Hines Harley-Davidson, a 4-time world champion, who might be the champ next year based on what we've learned this year, Eddie Krawick. She is a 9-time winner in the category. She won St. Louis for White Alligator Racing, Karen Stouffer. Number 3, he is the outgoing Mellow Yellow World Champ in category, Matt Smith. And number 2, he almost had it. The racing gods, they are fickle. Number 2 is a 2-time Chevrolet Performance U.S. Nationals winner and our 2016 series champion, Jerry Savoie. And they are your 2019 Mellow Yellow Pro Stock Motorcycle Top 10. And now it is time to honor our champions. He is familiar to all of us. He is our sport's winningest Pro Stock Motorcycle racer, and he started the season by resetting the world elapsed time record with a 6.72 second run and winning the 50th Amley Motor Oil NHRA Gator Nationals. Then he took home a milestone 50th career win at the 4-Wide Nationals in Charlotte, on to Atlanta, Richmond, Norwalk, Denver, Sonoma, along with a 7th Mickey Thompson Pro Bike Battle victory, and finally, the countdown race in Chicago and Charlotte. In all, his 8-win season is the best of his career, and it makes up 14% of his lifetime win total. He has credited hard work and a little anger to his victory. After 2018 saw his first winless season, he recommitted to physical training, he recommitted to his diet, and he recommitted to the focus on his riding that made him successful in the past. As is often the case in motorsports, however, things are not handed to anyone, and the racing gods, they can be cruel, or at very least, they have a sense of humor. As we all experienced at the Auto Club Finals, when a championship coronation turned into a gut-wrenching epic that will be remembered by all involved forever. In the end, the man who dominated NHRA 2019 now joins an elite group of only 9 other racers in NHRA history with 6 or more championships, and he ties Hall of Famer Dave Schultz. Let's take a look back at the 2019 Mellow Yellow Championship season.
Of the first 5 races of the NHRA season in Pro Stock Motorcycle. Yeah!
Gianna Salinas gets her first victory, and the wildest day in the history of this category is finally complete.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your 2019 Mellow Yellow Pro Stock Motorcycle World Championship crew, the Screamin' Eagle, Vance and Hines, Harley-Davidson team, and their rider, your champion, Andrew Hines. And now we'd like to welcome Al Rondon and NHRA President Glenn Cromwell to the stage for the most important part.
I'm going to leave this right here so I don't tap at the whole speech. So let me find my notes here because I don't do teleprompters very well. Man, how about this? Absolutely insane. So. All right, my speech is going to be in text format on social media any minute. Natalie's going to post that, so see you guys. No, but in all seriousness, Natalie, you rock social media this year, not just for me, but for the entire NHRA Pro Stock Motorcycle class. So thank you, Natalie. How about Carducci representing tonight, right? Look at Brian Lones. Look at all our guys. We're snazzed up. And this one's for Terry. Inconceivable. We talked about that all last night. That was probably the word of the dinner last night. Just absolutely just crazy. I think yesterday kind of set the new standard for crazy things can happen, right? So it's one for the ages. We're all glued to our phones nowadays, so like I said, I'm going to try and keep this thing steady so I can read this. Thank you to NHRA, Glenn Cromwell, National Dragster staff, and NHRA.TV crew. You guys give us a great place to go racing, and big thanks to Mellow Yellow and Al Rondon for keeping this series going strong. Let's see. My wife, Tanya, my son, Declan, Ryan, my daughter, Genevieve, my loves, my life, my future. I'm so excited to see what our next adventures hold. If it wasn't for Declan, Declan, stand up on your chair. I would have retired a couple years ago if it wasn't for that kid. The encouragement your child can give you is absolutely second to none. And he's kept me out here so long, so the rest of the motorcycle class can thank him. I was talking about that R word, so that's still on the table. We'll see how that goes. Mom and Dad, thank you for the faith to let me go down this road for so long. It's been absolutely incredible, and you've been supportive the whole way. My brother Matt, he set this team up to win. He's not here tonight, but I really thank him. We owe him a debt of gratitude. Terry Vance, the belief that I can do this and for not letting me quit a couple times. Mike Kennedy, our president of Vance & Hines, who used to be an executive at Harley-Davidson. He had an argument with Terry Vance when I was 17 years old and said, we need to put him on a Harley. Terry's like, no, we need to talk about this Harley contract. Get this thing going. This is probably back in 2000. And that's probably their first professional business argument they had. Finally, it worked out, and Mike got his way, and I was able to go racing. So thank you, Mike Kennedy. Comp cams, diamond pistons, total steel piston rings, Denso spark plugs, Motec ECUs, and Shane Tecklenburg for the never-ending support. CHE, first gear, full spectrum batteries, Mickey Thompson tires, and thank you for supporting the Pro Bike Battle. Us racers really appreciate having the bonus event in NHRA. Vance & Hines employees for making everything we can possibly imagine for our team. And now the rest of my crew, please stand up. I want to embarrass the heck out of you guys. Scott, he's our major power player, our engine guy. We can depend on him to push through about just about anything. We do make last-minute engine changes, and he's always able to get on top of it and get it done and execute. Ray, I call you chief. A lot of people call you governor. There's all kinds of other words out there for you. We love you to death. He dealt with the adversity this year of losing a vital part of our team that most of us take for granted, our truck and trailer. We were down a couple races, and we were traveling across the country with rented transportation or donated transportation. So thank you, Antron Brown. Mike Mullaney, my right-hand guy now. He's become an integral part of our team. He's our social butterfly. He's great in all aspects of chassis fab and everything he does to get those motorcycles together. Congrats on the baby this year, and I think we got some other big news professionally coming up for you soon. That's awesome. Jay Krawick, that's Krawick, another Krawick, just what we need in the pit area, right? A great new addition to the team. It was cool to see him persevere through some of the tough challenges this year. He was tabbed to be Angel's crew chief, and he pulled through and made sure he wasn't too stressed out. Also, we might have a few new dance moves tonight that Jay and Mike created last night thanks to that strenuous final round. I think we got the Jay walk and the Mike shuffle, so you'll see that on the dance floor tonight. Eddie, great teammate and better friend. We fought this year hard, man. Why am I crying for you? He's not leaving. The growth our team showed this year, it was positive and tremendous. One thing that leaves me burning this year, I won't say it, we're going to rectify it next year. My dad said he's pissed. Angel, Seth, and Ava, great family. They came onto our team this year and became our racing fam. I'm excited to see where our kids are going to grow up around this awesome sport. Can you believe after all the years of being the enemy, you actually missed Eddie this year before a race? I did too sometimes. That's a scary thought. This year started off great. Unbelievable results with an unproven chassis package entering the year. National record and starting off with a win and the adversity of not winning in 2018. We rolled through this year finding the luck at the right time and the performance when we needed it. And the luck, which I tell people all the time at the ropes, I'll take it because you need that more than skill almost any day. It followed us all the way to that last day of the races. Unfortunately for me, it was bad luck to start, but our team had good fortune at the end of the day, and I never thought at 12:32 or whatever it was when I crossed the finish line yesterday, when I saw that red light turn on, that I'd be experiencing this joy right now. But I knew at that point, at the end of the day, I had to give a speech. It's something. Look at that. That's what happens. He runs a business at the shop. I do the engineering, so obviously he's taking the money. But as our team moved through the day, they kept my head held high, and our jaws dropped as all those scenarios unfolded in front of us. It was just it's absolutely ridiculous, I think it was the word I used most of the day. We fought tough, all of us racers, but none of us had a better day than Gianna Salinas. So thank you for that. This year, we surpassed 100 wins for Harley-Davidson. Many have been a blur, but it's been great to have Vance and Hines be associated with Harley-Davidson. We're pushing fast at 20 years with that commitment. That's absolutely incredible. They've had a dedication to our class. They've been supportive of bringing in motorcycles that are show floor relevant into our class and making sure we have the latest models out in front of the fans and making sure they're midway on the display is absolutely top-notch. So thank you, Harley-Davidson. The engineers at Harley, Jim Brendelson, Tony Coffey, thank you for pushing forward. I'm excited to see what you have in store for us in the future. We want to bring it out to Pro Stock Motorcycle. The other champs, Erica, Robert, where are you? Steve, we had a heck of a year. Congratulations to you. We did not end yesterday like we wanted to. We wanted double hardware, darn it. But we did survive 1.5 points. I'm sure we'll all find time to reflect and shake our heads in disbelief, but right now, let's go send it and party our way into the night. Thank you, guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the Vice President of Racing Administration, Josh Peterson.
The NHRA Manufacturers Cup was established to recognize the automobile manufacturer who has earned the most points in Funny Car, Pro Stock, Super Stock, Stock, and Factory Stock Showdown. Tonight I am honored to award the 2019 Manufacturers Cup to Chevrolet. This will be Chevrolet's 24th year for winning the cup. Please help me congratulate Chevrolet and welcome to the stage Mark Kent to accept the award on behalf of Chevrolet.
Thank you, Josh. We at Chevrolet appreciate the opportunity to race in this great series, and it's an honor to accept this award for a record 24th time, and it's an honor that we never take lightly. Thank you to all of our Chevrolet drivers and owners and team members for making this possible. I'd also like to thank our Chevrolet team members, Roger Allen, Bob Phipps, Adam Falk, and Judy Dominic, who worked tirelessly behind the scenes to make this all possible. And and congratulations to Chevrolet's Robert Height and Erica Enders, along with Steve and Andrew on their championships. Job well done. And finally, I'd like to thank Peter Clifford, Glenn Cromwell, Ned Wallister, and everybody at NHRA for another great year. Now, I know this was not a sub-4-second run, but at 36 seconds, I think it was still pretty darn quick. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of your evening.
And now, Alan Reinhart.
Good evening, everybody. We're going to talk about Pro Stock in just a minute, but first I want to congratulate the rest of the champions. Andrew, I still haven't figured out how you did it, and I want to know what tuxedo you rejected before you went with that one. There had to be another one back there someplace. Gianna, I know you're back in the back of the room, and I want to add my congratulations with everybody else. What an incredible day you had yesterday. I was thinking when I got back to the hotel last night, everybody next to her yesterday basically blew up. And if she gets in the elevator, I'm taking the stairs because I'd be afraid I'd have an aneurysm before I got to the top. What an incredible day. Robert, another hard-fought battle. It's so fun watching the funny cars when the competition is as it is, and it's also fun when the leaders are going head-to-head battling it out for the championship. Congratulations. And Steve, it ain't easy when you got the number one on the wing and the target on your back, and you guys pulled it off again. So congratulations to all the other champions. Yeah. Anybody knows me knows I love Pro Stock. And this year it started with a new schedule and a whole lot of question marks. The shortened schedule was certainly a success in that every event had a full field and some had as many as 20 cars vying for a qualifying spot. It was also a year of incredible streaks. Can you believe to kick off the year, engines built by Greg and Jason won 5 of the first 6 races, while cars driven by Greg and Jason won none of the first 6 races? It's true. Jakey won Phoenix, but Elite would not get back into the winner's circle again until Seattle with Matt Hartford. They were knocking down rounds, just not closing the deal. But they obviously were warming up for a championship run, winning 4 of the last 7 races. All in all, those 2 engine shops accounted for every finalist except one, when Chris McGahey busted through for the ice cream scoop in Norwalk. When it was all over and the tire smoke cleared, KB had won the most battles, but Elite had won the war. Let's take a look at some of this year's highlights.
Has won yet another race here at Auto Club Raceway Pomona. The 1,000th round of racing for Jed Coughlin results in a win light. It is the 3rd race win of Derek Kramer's career. Chris McGahey picking up his first win at Norwalk, his 8th career Pro Stock win.
First time in a year, Greg Anderson wins. Congratulations to KB Racing.
It's at the top end, it's Matt Hartford on a hole shot, and Matt Hartford wins the Wally. For the first time properly in his home track, the Minnesota fans go nuts for their hometown boy. No, oh, she got outrun! You have got to be kidding me! By 88 ten-thousandths of a second, she has finally driven herself to the winner's circle in 2019.
What a year. And now let's meet the drivers that finished 10 through 2. He battled hard all year to make his first appearance in the countdown and ultimately finished 10th, first time on the stage. Welcome, Val Smeland. Continuing to be a big thorn in the side of the 2 engine building giants, he won Norwalk this year and finished 9th. Welcome, Chris McGahey. Breakage kept him from potentially winning in Gainesville, but breakage also gave him the U.S. Nationals. Finishing 8th this year, Alex Laughlin. This former champion's highlights include a near sweep on the Western Swing, the cowboy hat in Dallas, but the headlines are really the strategy he employed last weekend that ultimately didn't work out. Number 7, Greg Anderson. Wins at Route 66 and the fall stop in Norwalk were among the bright spots for the guy who still wears the Batman suit. And this year finished 6th, Derek Kramer. And now the top 5. The amended schedule gave this driver a chance to run for the championship for the first time, and he took full advantage of it. Racing his way into six finals and winning Seattle, it's his first countdown, and it ends with a top five finish for Matt Hartford. Two wins might be considered an off-season for this former champ, but he was in the thick of the points battle right down to literally the last day of the season, ultimately finishing fourth. For KB Racing, it's Jason Lyne. After announcing that he would not run the full schedule this year, the former champ changed his mind when it would require only 18 weekends and came out of the blocks winning four of the first five races. He also was in the mix all year, and next year will wear the number three. He is Bo Butner. The next driver's first win of the year came early, and his second came yesterday, but he continued to prove all year long that he's one of the most naturally gifted drivers that we have ever seen. Yesterday, he said he was all right with a number two finish, but only because his teammate was the champ. He is Jeg Coughlin Jr. And that brings us to the champion. She won back-to-back in 14 and 15, but a brand switch and rule changes got her team sidetracked for a while. But she never wavered that she loved her guys and they would get through the hard times together. They now have. She was so solid during the countdown that Greg Anderson decided to employ a strategy widely used in sportsman racing, trying to stop her and help his teammates have a chance. He shut off in qualifying, trying to match up with her first round, and against long odds, it worked on Saturday. On Sunday, however, Greg had an 0-16 light, ran the third quickest number in the first round, and she cracked him anyway. Guys, I mean this from the bottom of my heart. Don't stop the rivalry. The internet, the Twitter, the email, all of my feeds, that was one of the most talked about rounds of the year. Fans need something to root for, and you guys gave it to them. One of the most common things I heard yesterday or day before yesterday was, you know, I don't always watch Pro Stock, but I'm watching tomorrow. Remember that. They've got to have something to watch. It's good for the NHRA, and most importantly, it's good for the class. She joined Shirley Muldowney and Angel Sampe as three-time Mellow Yellow champions. Our Pro Stock champion, once again, Erica Enders. Video, please.
Of a second, she has finally driven herself to the winner's circle in 2019.
Got moved all the way down to number seven and moved it right back up.
.617 seconds, 208 miles an hour. Erica Enders will go to Pomona, California with a 92-point lead over the rest of the field. And at the finish line stripe, it's number three for Tripoli, a three-time world champion on a hole shot for Erica Enders. How appropriate.
case you didn't see it last night on social media, after they got through with championship videos or pictures, as has become a tradition, she drove that baby back. Everybody, let's welcome now the elite motorsports team that made her the champion. And let's welcome the lady that got it done, three-time champion, Erica Enders.
Thank you. Hello to everyone from NHRA, fellow Pro Stock competitors, champions, sponsors, and racers. Congratulations to the other champions tonight. It's an honor to share this day with you. Lots of people don't know that Robert Hyatt and I were in the same top alcohol funny car class at Hawley's school, or that Steve-O and I would load up the truck and trailer and go super comp racing back in the day. Who would have thought that tonight, all of those years ago, as sportsman rookies? And Andrew, six times, you're the man. I would also like to congratulate my fellow female world champions, Megan Meyer and Allison Dahl. Congratulations. People want to say that drag racing is a numbers game, speed and ET, that's all there is to it. Maybe there was a time in my life that I believed that as well, but not anymore. Drag racing is a sport of heart and soul, and it goes way beyond the numbers on a time slip. It is the heart and soul that has carried me and my entire elite motorsports team through some seasons that really sucked to go through. The heart and soul that drove us all to be better at the shop, on the dyno, and at the races. The heart and soul to show up when we had zero chance of winning, but we gave it hell anyway. It's the heart and soul that has me standing here tonight, much to the disappointment of some of the people in this room. In drag racing, you can have all the numbers, you can have all of the data, but if you don't have the heart and soul, you'll never win anything. Rick and Ricky always tell me on my radio, God is good. I thank God first because it's my faith in him that is the backbone to everything that I do. So I cannot talk about soul without bringing up my sister, Courtney. Woo! She's crazy, high energy, and the person I literally cannot live my life without. There is no one I can think of that has more impact on me in so many positive ways at the track and away from it. Courtney is a firecracker and is able to say and do all the things I literally cannot. And for the heart, my dad. He's my best friend in the world. He's my sounding board. He's my first stop for business and personal advice. He is self-made, successful, and continues to strive to be better every day. Courtney and I are blessed to have him as someone to look up to and guide us in our lives. Mom, thanks for helping to form a pair of championship sisters. Let's talk guts for a second. That's where our fearless leader, Richard Freeman, comes in. Richard did more to save Pro Stock and to bring the class back together than anyone will ever truly know. Without Richard putting me in the seat of this race car, my story would be totally different. I had six wins when I joined Richard's team. Now we have 24. We would not have three world championships in six seasons without the operation that you have built and continue to grow today. Thank you. They say in life that there is no gain without pain, no triumph without adversity, and no hero without a villain. In 2019, they brought all of those things to our doorstep at Elite. And that's why our third championship is possibly the most rewarding for me. Looking back, we at Elite have overcome so much. Brilliant rule-making decisions by the sanctioning body, a team brand swap, the move to EFI, significant changes in my personal life, and a supersized bucket of unnecessary nonsense in the sandbox we choose to play. With Jed Coughlin and I finishing 1-2, it seems like we finally might be back. Our other teammates and family, wow. Alex, Matt, and Aaron had great years as well. Next year is looking strong, and we certainly know that every other team out there will be motivated to make it interesting and ugly. Alex, I still love you, Indy and all. Well, there's only one person per car that can let the clutch out and shift the gears. This is a team sport, and I say it all the time, I love my guys so much. These people have had my back and my best interest in their hearts for as long as I have known them. Through the darkest days of my personal life, they were there. They are the reason why I am here. Richard, Royce Lee, Rick, Mark, Ricky, Lump, Jake, Kyle, Big Al, Casey, Kendall, Steven, Robert, Chase, Kelly, Keith, Cody, Michael, and Brett. You have played an amazing role in my lives. Thank you so much. As far as the guys who lay their hands on my car, Richard, Robert, Chase, my road dog, Jake, Rick, Mark, please stand up. All y'all stand up. I'm so proud of you guys. The women of Elite are as strong as the men. They keep the home fires burning when we are on the road, and their contributions to our success cannot go unmentioned. Kim, Kinley, Lisa, Jamie, all of the ladies that are here, thank you. We all know that race cars run on gasoline, hope, heart, soul, but they also run on money. And without the support of Mark Melling and his family who are here tonight, we wouldn't be here, so thank you. Also, thank you for signing an extension with us. Mark and Marshall Stockseth, they are also here tonight and their support spans multiple classes of NHRA racing. We are blessed to have their support and their help. Thank you, Mark and Marshall. Transportation Impact, Travis and Cass Burt, Keith and Ginger Bird with Harper Lee. We have a relationship that started when Elite was not as strong as we are now. You have been a part of that growth and our rise in strength. Thank you for sticking with us. Gallagher continues to be a big part of our success at Elite Motorsports as well. And I'm happy to tell you we have signed an extension with him, just as we have with Melling. So thank you, Kevin, for all your hard work, seriously. Stan and Sheila Holt of Lupe Tortilla, they're drag racers who just happen to make the greatest Mexican food on the planet. There's nothing better than their restaurant when I'm home in Houston. Thank you to PeopleLease for supporting our Pro Stock and Pro Mod operation. David at High Performance Lubricants, Carl and Bonnie Foltz at CFE, Paul Lee at McLeod, Jeg and the entire Coughlin family, Woody, you too. Ooh, ooh. Woody. Jeff Stange at Strange Engineering, the Hairston family, Jim, Kathy, Clint, Jake, y'all are the best, and I'm sorry for burning your race car to the ground. ProMod. Roger, Judy, Mark, and everyone at Chevrolet Performance, Steve and Lori Matusik at Aeromotive, Craig and Beverly Garland at RFC, my Texas people, thank you so much. Brian Brow, Adam Lambert, Rick and Ricky Jones at RJ Race Cars and Quartermax. Pete Merkel, thank you. You have no idea. Thank you. Tyler Hogan at Hogan Manifolds, Doug Lane at Lane Automotive, Justin Elks at Modern Racing, who is also my crew chief on our ProMod car, Mike Hewitt and Billy at Sparco, Bonafonte, Mac Tools, Lisa at Denso, girl, you rock. Brian Rock at Motor Shield, and Vic Wood at Weld Wheels. You are all instrumental in this championship. And to all the fans who have had the back of Elite Motorsports through the good years and the lean years, I'll never be able to put into words what your support means on a championship weekend where others were obviously gunning for us. You were louder than ever with your support. It really helped on Sunday morning, maybe even by 4,000. I'm a Texas girl with Texas friends who have given me Texas-sized support when I have needed it the most. You know who you are down there, and you know my heart as well as anyone. Thank you for always being there for me. I'm really excited about 2020 and beyond. I'm also really excited about the after party. Hopefully we can keep the ladies' MMA stuff to a minimum this year. Thank you all. I can't wait to represent Pro Stock as a world champion in 2020.
Ladies and gentlemen, two-time funny car champion, Tony Pendragon.
Since 1996, the NHRA and the Automobile Club of Southern California have recognized the top rookie competitor, along with the nation's leading auto journalists. A winner is selected through a voting system based on the following criteria: number of events competed in, performance on and off the racetrack, participation in NHRA promotions, and relationships with fans, sponsors, and the media. Tonight, we are in the company of many past Auto Club Road to the Future, also known as Rookie of the Award winners, including myself. And I can tell you from my personal experience that among any accomplishments that a driver can achieve early in their racing career, this ranks alongside of a championship. And if we can, take a moment and ask all of our past Road to the Future Award winners to please stand, and let's give them a round of applause for their achievement. Now, this year, we do have one of the most diverse groups that this award has seen, and it's guaranteed to make you forget all about last year's. The seven candidates for the prestigious award in 2019 are, in alphabetical order, Christian Cuadra, Pro Stock, Fernando Cuadra Jr., also on Pro Stock, Cameron Ferrey, Top Fuel, Lex June, Top Fuel, Austin Prock, Top Fuel, get ready for this one, Gianna Salinas, Pro Stock Motorcycle, and Jordan Vandergriff, Top Fuel. Let's take a look at the 2019 Automobile Club of Southern California Road to the Future winner.
Start for the young man from Indiana.
Well, Austin Prock's a special kid.
Steve Torrance smokes the tires and it is perfect symmetry. Austin Prock collects his first career victory. Does it again. A reaction time more than halfway better than Brittany Force's. An 053 light and a whole shot victory.
He goes 3.948 seconds and left a full tenth of a second ahead of Mike Salinas.
Yeah,
okay. Oh, he was, so we're good?
Yep.
Okay, I told you you're climbing that mountain, kid.
You'll be okay.
All right, I ain't got no script, and I'm going to shoot from the hip. But we're going to have some fun tonight. I say a lot, so we're going to make a game out of this. Every time I say you guys drink, and by the end of this, this is going to be unbelievable. You know, this is all about where you start from. You know, growing up racing circle track, people like Tony Stewart, Jimmy Carr, my brother Thomas, you know, molding me into who I am today. It's been an unbelievable journey, and I can't thank those guys enough. You know, me and Thomas starting at 10 years old. You know, we wanted to go racing, and my dad said, if you want to do it, you better, you know, bust your tail and do it on your own. So we would prepare the cars ourselves. We'd work on them at the track, and my mom, Jill, would drive us to the racetrack, drive the rig there, and we'd get her done and, you know, try and get as many checkered flags as we could. So that's where it all starts. But, you know, I didn't even think I would be in contingency to win this deal this year. We came into this deal and we didn't have a sponsorship, you know. John Force, he worked his tail off all winter long, and 7 days before Pomona, we found out we had a sponsorship, and it was me, John Schaefer, and Ronnie Thompson busting our tails all winter trying to get this race car to get put together. And Frank Teagues came in and saved our day. It was a miracle. You know, we were starting to get our hopes down, and he came through and made this deal happen. You know, we've had over 46 people work on this race car this winter, or this year, excuse me, and we came through with a dream team. You know, I've had an unbelievable team this year, and they're the reason why I'm up here right now. They made no mistakes all season long, and it gave me the opportunity to do my job and succeed. So kudos to them. You know, my dad, he's one of the greatest out here, you know, and he's going to be up on the stage shortly. He got his third championship, and I can't thank him for everything that he's taught me throughout my life. You know, the best advice he gave me is in Pomona. He told me, he come up and he said, hey, you got a great opportunity in front of you, and don't F this up, you know. Short, sweet, and simple, and I took it to heart, though, and you know, that's one of the reasons I'm up here right now. Just unbelievable. John Force, he's given me the opportunity to be in Eric Medlin's shoes. Eric Medlin was one of my heroes. You know, we were best friends, and this is the closest I'll ever be to being Eric Medlin, you know. So it's just, I can't even believe I'm up here. So thank you, guys. Thanks for coming out tonight. Thanks for supporting me. And I probably missed a few people. Thank you, Montana Brand, Advance Auto Parts, Peak, Chevrolet, and AAA for, you know, putting this prestigious award up. You know, many, many, many drivers that received this award have come through and won world champions. And Robert Height, he's going to be up here shortly, and that's who I strive to be.
Ladies and gentlemen, two-time funny car champion, Tony Pendragon.
Rather than me come up here and tell you that it was exciting, I've been trained to tell you why. On Sunday morning, five funny car drivers and teams were mathematically in the running for a championship. And when a championship is decided at the final race and in the final round, we, our fans, and our viewers stay engaged until the end. Unfortunately, only one team can leave with the championship. But here are our drivers 10 through 2 that made it one for the books.
A spectacular final round, but it's Robert Height. Matt Hagen trucks down to the top end, collecting that third victory at Wild Horse Bass Motorsports Park. The top end, it's going to be J.R. Todd.
Hey. Hey. Sean Langdon gets his first funny car win. Hey.
and it's Ron Capps on a hole shot. His 61st career win in the Nitro Funny Car category. Johnson explodes in a dramatic fashion, wins in Chicago. Woo! A starting line advantage for Tasca. Bob Tasca picking up his first win in nearly 7 years. And at the finish line, it's John Forrest for the 150th time in the greatest career in NHRA history. He's done it. Jack Beckman gets the victory here. In his sixth final round of the year, he collects his first win.
Now, let's introduce the top 10 that made it one for the books. Number 10, always a fan favorite, Tim Wilkerson. Finishing number 9 with 2 wins and joining the not-so-exclusive club of drivers that have had 1 win in Top Fuel as well as 1 win in Funny Car, Sean Langdon. And finishing number 8, a driver that does make wishes come true and with 2 wins this year, Tommy Johnson Jr. And finishing 7th, the DHL Toyota driver, the outgoing champion with 1 victory this year, J.R. Todd. And finishing 6th, a multi-time race winner this season and a perennial top 10 finisher, Ron Capps. Now for your top 5, with his first top 5 finish and looking to improve that, Bob Tasca the 3rd. Now finishing 4th, scoring his 150th win this year and also the biggest race of the year at the U.S. Nationals, the John Force. And finishing 3rd with 4 victories, and Matt, one heck of a run at the championship, Matt Hagan. And the other part of that exciting finish, and earning both of his wins in the countdown, Jack Beckman. Let's hear it one more time for the top 10 through 2 in Funny Car. Robert, before I go on script, I think there's a lot of drivers that were backstage that have always wanted to do a long burnout, you know, like recently, and I think we figured out that things have changed quite a bit. I even wanted to do that when I quit racing, and I'm glad I didn't. But the Auto Club team showed the Funny Car class how to dominate, winning 6 races in 8 finals. Now, many of us in the room have been around long enough to know that there are a group of teams that have all the talent and all the parts and all the resources that are needed to win. But when you have 10 teams that have those same resources, what is it that's going to separate one from the rest? Well, that can only be chemistry. That's the relationship and the interaction that a group of people can only have when they've worked and won and lost together. And Jimmy Prock and Chris Cunningham deserve a lot of credit and a lot of praise for all the hours and time at the track, away from the track. And they also lead a group of guys that have proven And I hear this all the time, the best in the world, but they have proven to be the best team in Funny Car. Let's introduce the Automobile Club team.
Spectacular final round, but it's Robert Height. 3.881 seconds beats 3.880 seconds.
This is unbelievable. Yes!
It's going to be Robert Height. 3.941 seconds, 310 miles an hour. Beckman's going to try to take it to the mat, and it's Robert Height. 3.895 seconds at 330 miles per hour.
Cornwell Tools, Denso, everybody, thank you. Yeah!
And for the 50th time in his career, Robert Height is going to raise a Wally at the end of an NHRA national event. What a battle. Hagen's trying to hang on to it, but it's Robert Height. 3.977 seconds, 324.59 miles per hour.
And now, the three-time Funny Car champion, Robert Height.
I want these guys to stay up here for just a few minutes. I want to introduce each and every one of them. Let's pull out here a little bit, Lanny. Everybody at an angle. There we go. Nope. Other way, Lanny. Lanny Maglisi does the track. Next. Mike Riggs does racks. Corey Melton does the body and tires. Nate Hildahl, clutch guy. Jeff, I forgot your last name. Acacian, sorry. Yeah, sorry. He's a new guy. He does the bottom end and builds the short blocks. Justin Covarrubias, Superchargers. Chris Adams, Cylinder Heads. My biggest supporter, Autumn. Ryan Heilson, Car Chief. I want to tell you a story about these two guys, who I think are the smartest guys in the business. So they're cruising their motorhomes down to Bristol this year, and they stop at a truck stop, and Autumn is actually with Jimmy and Jill, and she sends me a text. She says, "Dad, don't tell Jimmy I told you this, but they just got scammed at this truck stop." And as it turned out, they fell for this card game. And I don't know the whole story. I've gotten bits and pieces. But they fell for this card game, and then some guy that had won the lottery and was giving money away. But I think they ended up losing about $400 a piece. That's my boys.
We're good.
I'm out.
We'll play cards later, guys. I used to hate giving speeches. Actually, I still do. Everyone tells you that it gets easier the more you do it. I think that's total BS. I first want to congratulate everyone, all the 2019 champions, Steve Torrance, Erica Enders, and Andrew Hines. Great job to all of you and your teams. Until yesterday, I always thought if I was going to go into a brawl, I would want to bring Matt Hagen with me. But now I think Steve Torrance is my guy. This season has been amazing, one that you can only dream about. I've always wanted to win a championship that the countdown didn't reflect the outcome. We were the best funny car from start to finish, and we actually had a change of the guard. We had three new crew members. I was a little nervous going into the season, but it really, I give it to my veteran guys. They stepped up and they really took the new guys under their wings and made it happen. You know, right from the start, we were where we needed to be. But this car never struggled. We were always competitive everywhere we went. And every single weekend, we had a chance to win because of all these guys. I wouldn't have wanted to experience this season with anybody besides Jimmy, Chris, and the entire Auto Club team. Yesterday was the most stressful day of racing I have ever experienced. Coming into the weekend, I lost the last two races. In Dallas, I red lit. In Vegas, I got beat on a hole shot. So basically, my confidence was as low as it could go. But I had four guys behind me, and they're all champions. I had to like figure it out and get it together. First, I have to race the boss first round. And I really feel that the Peak team has had the best team out here since Seattle, period. They've made the best runs, gone up and down the track more than anybody else. Then I get Langdon second round. He's got a great running car, and we know that guy can leave the starting line. And then you have to go up against Hagen in the semis for an all or nothing pressure cooker run. And we got the job done, guys. I kept trying to tell myself, this is just another run, okay? Treat it like it's just another run, but you can't lie to yourself, okay? It means a lot to win a championship, and I know that when I was staging, my heart felt like it was beating out of my chest. It's crazy. But when we got that wind light on the wall, the weight was lifted. It was the best feeling you could ever have. And now, guys, we're three-time Mellow Yellow Funny Car champs. And it puts us in an elite group. Hard for me to believe that I'm on a list with Don Perdomo, Raymond Beadle, Kenny Bernstein, and John Force. I'm not sure I belong there. This is my 15th season driving the Auto Club Funny Car, and very few drivers can say they've had the same sponsor for the entire career. I can honestly say that I am partnered with the greatest company in motorsports. Without the Auto Club, not even that first win would be possible, let alone three funny car championships. I'm very proud that the Auto Club sees a value in John Force Racing and the NHRA drag racing. This sport would not be the same without their support. I am blown away by the pride of the Auto Club members. Every year, thousands of them come and have me sign their cards, show me how many years they've been a member. They are very proud of that. And I think the applause that I got when I asked the crowd yesterday how many Auto Club members were in attendance was bigger than the applause I got for that big old long burnout. I want to recognize all the folks that are in attendance tonight from the Auto Club. Tom McKernan, the man that started and continues to support this program. Not only is he my boss, he's a great friend, and we get to go out shooting together too. His daughter, Megan McKernan, who is also an NHRA drag racer. And will John McQueen, Robert Galvin, and Chad Light please stand? Thank you for all of your hard work that keeps this program running so smooth, guys. And I hope you have a spot for this trophy at headquarters. It's going to be the third one there. And how about Chevrolet winning the Manufacturers Cup for 26th time? That's amazing. These wins and championships are not possible without you. Thank you for all your technical and engineering support. I want to recognize the folks in attendance from Chevrolet tonight, Mark Kent, Roger Allen, and Judy Dominic. Please stand. Thank you, guys. Congratulations to the Peak team led by John Force, Brian Carotti, and Daniel Hood on a great season. Winning number 150 and Indy, it's pretty amazing, guys. The Advance Auto Parts team with Brittany Force, David Grubnick, and Max Savage gave it a run right to the end. Dave, Mac, the entire team have been a great addition to John Force Racing. Glad to have you guys. And how about our Auto Club Road to the Future winner, Austin Prock, driving the Montana brand Top Fuel Dragster. He and crew chiefs Mike Green, Ronnie Thompson did a great job, and they're going to be tough next year, I promise. It's also pretty cool to have the snake hanging out with us this year. If you guys could only hear John Force and the snake in sponsor negotiations, it's almost a comedy act. It is unbelievable. Two different styles, and it's I'm pretty lucky that I get to be in there and listen and watch. I want to give everybody back in Brownsburg a shout out at Force American Made. You guys and gals give us the best of everything, and none of this would be possible without each and every one of you. Kelly Antonelli, our marketing director, a title that doesn't encompass the scope of responsibilities she takes on, and I'm not sure that there is a title that would. Thank you for keeping this ship afloat, Kelly. Sarah Slaughter, Kelly Kara Dement, thanks for the great job you guys do with PR and social media. And I promise I'm going to start posting more things myself. Now for all the partners that make all this happen. PPG, Cornwell Tools, Parker Store, Baldwin Filters, Denso. Lisa's here from Denso. Thank you, Lisa. Goodyear, Herco, Gates Belts, Pit Boss Grills, Simpson Safety Equipment, Weld Wheels, Molly and Clevite. Thank you for all your support. I'm speaking for all the teams when I say how much we appreciate the support that Mellow Yellow and Coca-Cola Company give the NHRA. I want to thank John Force and Lori Force for giving me this opportunity, and I want to wish everybody a great off season and happy holidays. Thank you.
Please welcome the Vice President of Competition, Ned Walliser.
Good evening. As we celebrate our talented drivers tonight, we want to take a moment and recognize those who often remain behind the scenes, the crew members, the crew chiefs, without whom none of this would be possible. Crew chiefs and crew members are the backbone of our competition. Their technical insight and constant innovation drive this sport as they continued to push the envelope. Let's take a look at this dedicated group.
They say teamwork make the dream work. Everybody trying to last, but we first. Need another one for the back as we work. Harder than everybody, now watch the teamwork. Teamwork, yeah, teamwork. Watch the teamwork, watch the teamwork. Everybody on their job, watch the teamwork. Everybody hustle hard, that's all my teamwork, yeah. I'm Jordan with the beat, Tyson in the fight. Feel like Wayne, that's how I drip a ice. Counting on my team, I make it through the night. We can cut the cream and worry about the price. We ready for whatever, we do it together. Everybody focused, trying to live forever. Banging like a storm, you should've checked the weather. Calling us the best, cause we do it better. Love, ain't no I in team, but there's an I in win. Got my eyes on the finish line before I begin. The way I run on the track, feel like I got wings. Yeah, cause if I win, then we all win. Can't stop till my whole squad ballin'. That's the definition of a champion. Working with your team to do what can't be done. They say teamwork make the dream work. Everybody tryna last, but we first. Need another one for the bag, cause we work harder than everybody, now watch the teamwork. Teamwork, yeah, teamwork. Watch the teamwork, watch the teamwork. Everybody on their job, watch the teamwork. Everybody hustle hard, that's all my teamwork, yeah. I'm Jordan with the beat, Tyson in the fight. Feel like Wayne, that's how I drip a ice. Counting on my team, I make it through the night. We can cut the cream and worry about the price.
Tonight, we honor one crew chief who has demonstrated such commitment, ingenuity, and passion for the sport of drag racing with the Lifetime Achievement Award. Austin Coyle started his career in drag racing in the 1960s. When he partnered with John Farkonis and Pat Minnick on the famed Chi-Town Hustler Funny Car that popularized the burnout. He tuned the Chi-Town Hustler Funny Car driver Frank Hawley to back-to-back championships in 1982 and 1983. Then he joined forces with a young, talented driver, tuning him to his first 132 wins and 15 championships. That driver was none other than John Force. Overall, Austin Coyle is responsible for 139 career wins and 17 championships. He served as a constant innovator in many aspects of drag racing engineering, including high-volume fuel pumps, superchargers, and intake manifolds. Not only is Austin an important part of history of NHRA drag racing, he is also part of the future. He's mentored top minds in the sport today, including Jimmy Prock, Mike Neff, and Dean Antonelli. Let's take a look at the NHRA Lifetime Achievement Award recipient.
There's some things that you still obviously want to aspire to do with John or with somebody else or whatever?
Well, the thing I'd like to do the most is I'd like to be world champion in funny car drag racing more times than anyone else ever has. Turned out that superstock car just about bankrupted me, and I was on the verge of hanging it up when the machine shop that I was doing some work with introduced me to these guys that had just built a funny car that were superstock heroes of Farkonis and Minnick.
Frank Hawley has been dominating that left-hand lane, and the parachute comes out on Tim Gross's car. as the Chi-Town Hustler picks up Gator Nationals Championship.
Loved all over the country for its long, powerful burnouts, has now proven to be championship caliber as well.
Frank had decided he was going to quit from the driving seat, and we didn't have the sponsor support that we hoped we'd have to continue on into the next season. John essentially gave me a call and pretty much made an offer to me I couldn't refuse.
Me and Coyle, we fight and wrestle weekly, but I tell you something, people don't know what it takes to be champion. We may lose the next one, we may not, but right now what we've been trying for the last month is finally starting to work.
And across the finish line first is John Force.
They made a mistake here. They gave me Austin Coyle and the best team.
He's very hyperactive, has to be one of the best promoters in the sport. Obviously, I know nothing about the promotional end of the business, and so we need each other. And together, we're probably one of the absolute best teams in the sport of drag racing. You never quite ever get the perfect barbecued rib, just like you never get the quite perfect race car run. So, you know, you're always striving to make it just a little bit better the next time around.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the recipient of the NHRA Lifetime Achievement Award, Mr. Austin Coyle, and his driver, John Force.
Well, thank you, everybody. This is quite an honor, and when I first found out about it, I was trying to figure out if I could get my tired old legs to haul me down here. And, you know, it's all the people that you hang out with is what makes the real difference. And, you know, it started so long ago that the first guys I learned a lot of important things from are no longer with us. You know, like John Farkonis taught me how to be an engineer. Pat Minnick showed me how you didn't have to stuff the throttle to the floor to make a good run and win the race. And Keith Black was a tremendous mentor at one time. Well, they're no longer here. And really, I wish Bernie was with us here tonight, because I'm sure that most of those wins wouldn't have happened if Bernie wasn't there to help with the program. And you know, I was fortunate that the most of my career was during a time period when you were allowed to innovate and develop and create new things, and that was certainly where, you know, our strong suit was, that if there'd be a rules change and you had to make a lot of things different, oh, heck, that was going to be good for us, you know. And, you know, but the emotions of racing is so terribly strong. You know, you see outbursts all the time from people that you wouldn't expect that of. And to keep yourself in the focus, it takes something that doesn't get mentioned nearly enough. And that would be a really good woman by your side to tell you that, you know, that you can do this whether you think you can or not. And that's what Lisa did for me during so many years that I was losing faith in myself and thinking, well, you know, my best years are gone. And, you know, and she'd tell me, no, that ain't the truth, you know, and just pushed me to keep on going harder and faster and trying more and more. And she used that same tenacity in her battle with cancer over the last few years, and I do seriously believe she has won that battle, although, you know, she's still in a bit of recovery mode, but she's going to be okay. And, you know, there's so many folks out there that did so much. Obviously, without John Force being able to promote the money to move ahead at the rate we did, oh my goodness, at one time, you know, we had 27 CNC machines running all the time, just making stuff. Some of it never made it out of the shop, but it were ideas that we needed to try. And, you know, it made for like a heck of a season. And I think I was lucky enough to be in it at a time to where the innovation, you know, really paid off. And, you know, there's really not much more to say. I think Robert mentioned everybody in the room, you know. And if not, I'm sure there's a few others left that will. And I just want to say thank you, everybody, so much. And it's just a great honor to get this award. And hopefully I'll be around a few more years to see what happens next. Thank you. In case you didn't know, this is the best driver I ever had right here.
Greatest tuner, greatest friend, greatest husband. You know, Perdome, you summed it up. You said this guy had to listen to you for 30 years and 16 years on this stage. And you summed it up best, Snake. You always throw me under the bus. You said I wouldn't shit without Austin Coyle.
Once again, Brian Loans.
All right, so I'm just going to stand here and follow Austin Coyle and John Force, which is a giant disaster. But that's fine. We're going to talk about Top Fuel right now. It is the last category we're going to have on the stage tonight. It is the oldest category in the Male Yellow Drag Racing Series professional level. The 900th Top Fuel race of all time happened in 2019. 1963 Winter Nationals was the first time there was ever a class called Top Fuel. And the interesting thing about this category for 2019, 44 different people recorded points in Top Fuel during the 2019 season. Most of anybody, or most category, or most participants of any professional category we had. Most Rookie of the Year candidates came out of Top Fuel. It's awesome. The competition level is incredible. They say the competition improves the breed. Competition breeds success. When we look at Top Fuel, we see an incredible amount of people coming into this category over the next couple of seasons, young drivers that want to prove their mettle against the people that we're going to be introducing on the stage tonight. The points battle in 2019 for Top Fuel was incredible. Coming into the Pomona, coming into the World Finals, 16 points separated the number one and two drivers, and it tightened up between that gap before the end of the weekend. So our final category tonight is Top Fuel. We're going to take a brief look back at a season that will long be talked about in the annals of NHRA history in Top Fuel Eliminator. Coletta, 4.01, takes the win line. Leah smokes the tires, Billy smokes the tires, and he will pedal himself to his second career Top Fuel National Event win.
Down the drain strip they go. Header flames up, and it's Richie Crampton on a hole shot. And it's going to be Mike Salinas picking up his first ever NHRA Top Fuel Championship win. It's Steve Torrance. And Steve Torrance joins the Swamp Rat, Don Garlitz, with his 35th race win. Austin Prock collects his first career victory. And Leah Pritchett breaks the Top Fuel drought for Don Schumacher Racing.
Pretty awesome stuff over the season and Top Fuel Eliminator all the way through the year from Pomona to Pomona. One of the things that's interesting is we have a lot of fans, as I'm sure most racers know, and a lot of people that manage social media that like to, they ask, let's call them questions, when they tell you how bad you are at your job or a bunch of other stuff like that. Usually I hear that on Mondays. But one of the things that I feel like is a bridge in my job with Top Fuel and a lot of our categories is when you listen to the old races, Dave McClellan, Steve Evans, whoever was calling the race, it was always Top Fuel Eliminator. And on Sunday mornings, I always say Top Fuel Eliminator to start our mornings. And some of the younger fans don't understand kind of what that means and why I'm saying it. But the reality is, as I mentioned to start this off, it's the oldest category we have. I feel like it's a root in which the rest of this kind of spring comes out of. So if anybody busts your chops about listening to me say Top Fuel Eliminator, just tell them it's the right way. Now we're going to go down to top 10. So we're going to start with number 10. He is the pride of Drummond's, Tennessee. His name is Clay Milliken. The guy always has a smile on his face like he does tonight. I would argue second best jacket of the evening. Maybe 1A, 1-1A. The number 9 finisher in Top Fuel Eliminator this year. He is number 4 in the all-time win list. His name is Antron Brown. It was the auspicious debut at the 2019 Winter Nationals when he pedaled his way to his first ever round victory that got all of our attention. It was reaction time average over the course of the year that really kept our attention. The number 8 finisher is Austin Prock. The shoes say Pee Wee Herman, but the physicality says Olympian. That is a mix of, it's a mix of man that somebody's lucky to have Joanna Dunn. Anyway, the number 7 finisher, a self-made businessman, a hard runner, a guy who loves drag racing to the core of his being, a man who won a very emotional drag race on Father's Day at Bristol, Tennessee. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Salinas. So they told me this guy wasn't showing up. Now I talked to him on Sunday. He said he's showing up to go to rehearsal today. These guys are telling me this guy's not gonna be here. Guy who wins the 50th Gator Nationals, says he's not gonna be here. Guy who wins the first race of the countdown, he's not showing up. Guy who's in the final round at the finals isn't coming. Oh, he's here. His name is Richie Crampton, ladies and gentlemen. He is here. Natural ability. Let's talk about natural ability for the guy who's coming out next. This guy is a super comp divisional champion, a sportsman racer his whole life, another of the self-made men, self-made people that are in this room. He is responsible, whether you like it or not, for the existence of Steve Torrance. Ladies and gentlemen, Billy Torrance, the number 5 finisher and Top Fuel Eliminator. She won in Brainerd, Minnesota. She flirted with the title all the way to the end of the season. Ladies and gentlemen, the number 4 finisher in Top Fuel, Leah Pritchett. She made the guy that would eventually hold the crown shake in his boots. She did it in Vegas. She did it with style. She did it at 334 miles an hour. A new crew, a new team, a new crew chief, and your number three finisher in Top Fuel, none other than Brittany Forrest. When the dust settled yesterday, when it got quiet, before Palmer made rips in his Nitro Pro Mod last night in the pits, before any of that stuff happened, there was a moment of pause at the end of the finals. And this guy who was so respected, this guy who was understood to be one of, if not the greatest, driver to ever strap into a Top Fuel dragster, came up three brutal, stinking, miserable points out of a championship spot. He is a perennial contender. He will be a perennial contender until he wins a world championship. Ladies and gentlemen, Doug Coletta, the runner-up and Top Fuel Eliminator. There are people in this world that are like human jackhammers, these people that just don't stop. They chip and they grind and they fight and they hammer until they get where they want to go. They don't stop, they don't give up. They run into obstacles, obstacles that stop not just professional aspirations, but stop people's lives. This is not a person who does any of that stuff. This is not a guy who looks at an obstacle like a Top Fuel championship is something that's insurmountable, who looks into different challenges in his life of things he can't conquer because he's conquered some of the ultimate challenges in his life. A dominating regular season led to a countdown that was anything but like the countdown in 2018. They were in the table last year. We gave him a wrestling belt because what else are you going to do? This guy wins everything. That wasn't the case in 2019. The most awesome thing about 2019 for our Top Fuel champion is the fact that he had to go down in the trench with his team. They had to get down on their knees, and they had to gut and grind and fight. It was tooth and nail. How tooth and nail was it? Let's take a look.
This year.
And it's Steve Torrence. The team has climbed back atop the Top Fuel ranks. Steve Torrence does it again. A humongous starting line advantage for Torrence, and it's four in a row. Steve Torrence is now five races along in an incredible, incredible streak. With his 35th race win. Amazing. It is his eighth win this season. Oh, 31 reaction time for Steve Torrence. Doug Coletta smokes the tires, and for the first time since Denver, Steve Torrence is a Top Fuel winner. Both drivers at pre-stage. The season on the line for Brittany and Steve. Steve's out first. Brittany Forrest charging to the stripe, but it's Torrence. The 2019 Top Fuel World Champion is Steve Torrence.
We welcome this group of incredibly talented technicians and mechanics to the stage right now, led by Bobby Lagana and Richard Hogan. It's the Capco Contractors Top Fuel Team and their driver, Mr. Steve Torrence. Your 2019 Top Fuel World Champion.
Pretty unreal, guys. Every one of those guys that were standing here, they're the guys that deserve to be standing here and talking, because I'm just the guy that sits in the seat and tries not to run over anything. I had this on the bottom of my list, but first and foremost, I want to congratulate all of the other champions. Andrew Hines, you're just a badass, man. Erica, we've grown up racing together since we was 15 years old. Congratulations on your third championship. Robert, you're just a bad man. Yesterday was not one of my prouder days, so Cameron Ferre, you're somewhere over here. I heard all your fans hollering for you. I'm sorry, brother. In the heat of the moment, I got out of line. It's probably more tough to stand up here and admit that in front of all y'all than y'all probably know, but I was out of line and I apologize to you, brother. That was wrong. I also gotta say, as Capco, we sponsor a lot of junior drag racers. And a lot of those kids look up to me. I see a lot of kids with Capco on their car. I'm sorry to all those families and all those kids. I give all the glory to God, and I fall short a lot. Brittany, I know you're somewhere. This has been a fun 3 years. You kicked my butt. You kicked my butt again in Vegas and made me like it, had me shaking in my boots. Good job, great season to you. Grubby, Max Savage, you guys are savage. We can't go 65. We got to figure out how, but good job. Doug, I hate to say it, but I was rooting for you more than anybody. You are my hero, man. You just, I don't know, you gotta get, yeah, I think you fell in luck repelling or something, because that deal at Vegas, it should be you here. Great job to that whole team, that Mac Tools team and Doug Kalita. Thank you for being a good role model for all of us. I went through a lot of stuff last year and mentioned every one of those guys. I'm just gonna call your names out. Bobby Lagana, you're the blood of this team, brother. You keep us together. You're just as hot-headed and crazy as I am, but nobody gets to see it. Justin Crossland, you are my conscience. I should listen to you a lot more. Gary Pritchett, 37 wins, 2 championships, and we're standing here together. Original gangster. And look at that jacket he's got on. 5 o'clock shadow. Kale Hood, Mike Cleaver, Pops, Killer, stand up. Mike Giafino. He left last year. He left a few years ago and went across the pond with Belushi. He came back. When we handed out rings this year, I said, Mikey, I sure wish I could hand you one of these things, brother. And he goes, well, let's do it this year. I get to hand you one this year, brother. Chris Martin. I should listen to you a lot more, too. Jim Caffey. Jim's the airplane driver. We count on him a lot. Clark Papke. If anybody saw him last night, he was the guy with my cowboy hat on and looked like Howdy Doody. Dom Lagana. I'm sorry you've had to put up with Bobby so long. We were trying to save you, brother. Every one of those guys that, Bobby, that you handpicked for my dad's team, I cannot thank you enough. You guys put together a team for my dad, and he got in the race car and he did an unbelievable job driving it. Jason McCullough, Walt Prisbel, Stewie, all of those guys, thank you for putting that team together. And I'm so proud of that team, because he's hard to deal with, especially when he thinks he can tune it, and I mean, it's just not a super comp car, Dad. Thank you for the opportunity to do this, for the chance to race as a family. To go out and do this and see the success that you've had, and just the drive and the competitiveness that you display, and the striving to go win a race and be in the shop at 4 o'clock in the morning practicing on the practice tree. The only other person I know that does that is Austin Prock. Austin, while I'm thinking of it, great job, brother. I'm really proud of you. You've done an amazing job this year. That kid, everybody's seen it. He can drive, especially that pedal job he did at the first of the year. I thought it was luck, but it wasn't. He's good. He's really good. And he'll talk crap to you when he's got you by a thou on the tree, too. Mama Kay, thank you for looking after all of us. She really is the blood of this team. She keeps us all together. She even keeps Bobby in line. I don't know how that happens. Nat, Austin Cole said it best. You got to have a good woman to get your head back in the game sometimes, and I needed that yesterday. Thank you. Thank you for supporting me, for being behind me. Thank you. I want to congratulate everybody on a great year, a wonderful season. Again, I want to apologize for my actions. I look forward to seeing all of you again soon. I hope the off season seems longer than it did last year, and I hope the season lasts longer, because Brittany said it to me in 17. She said, you know, I was the champion and that year went by so quick, and this year has gone by so fast, and you just got to try to cherish it and enjoy it. All of you guys have a Merry Christmas, a Happy Thanksgiving, and a Happy New Year's, and thank you all, and God bless.
With that, let's give one more ovation for our world champions tonight. One more ovation for our world champions. All four of them and our sportsman world champions that are here tonight. Pretty much the end of the night. A couple of quick notes here, though. The first one is, drag racers, as you know, especially the family members of drag racers, are usually bad at organizing things, right? So we got all these people running around here with these headsets on. Evan Jonat's got one of them on. He's like Gilman from the Regis Philbin show over here, making sure people know where they're going. John Badia's around here, but the real all-stars of this whole program, Melissa Coleman and Hannah Rickards, come out here. They worked all night long to organize the racers, the drivers to come out. They've done a spectacular job. They're awesome. They also get to wear the cool headset. We're going down to the Hard Rock Cafe, okay? The Hard Rock Cafe is at street level of this facility. There is some sort of way less cool party than ours letting out down there right about now. Just walk over top of those people. Go in the side door is the message here. So the side door is going to be open at the Hard Rock when you go down there. If you try to go around the front, it's going to be a big mess. So just go in the side like most of you do in your normal life anyway. So go in the side door. That's going to be where it's at. The after party starts pretty much right now. This is it. 2018 season or 2019 season is in the books. It's over with. The points have been reset to zero. We will see you back here in Southern California in about 80 days for the 2020 NHRA Circle K Winter Nationals. Thank you all so much. Have a fantastic evening. Good night.